Hello friends, today we are going to talk about abortion. An abortion is the ending of pregnancy by removal or expulsion of an embryo or fetus before it can survive outside of the uterus. Around 56 million abortions are performed each year in the world, with about 45% done unsafely. So, the WHO recommends safe and legal abortion be available to all women. In this presentation, we will cover definition, classification, etiology, clinical manifestation, as well as management includes medical and surgical. According to WHO, the abortion is the expulsion or extraction from its mother of an embryo or fetus weighing 5 grams or less when it is not capable of independent survival. Abortion is divided into two types, spontaneous and induced. Spontaneous abortion is also known as miscarriage. It is the natural death of an embryo or fetus before it is able to survive independently. Spontaneous abortion also divided into six types, threatened, inevitable, complete, incomplete, missed, and septic. The second type is induced, which is divided into two types, legal and illegal. We have here etiology. The etiology of miscarriage is often complex and obscure. The following factors are important. First one is genetic. Majority of early miscarriages are due to chromosomal abnormality into conceptors. Autosomal trisomy is common one. The most common trisomy leading to miscarriage is trisomy 16. Polyploidy. Polyploidy refers to presence of three or more multiples of a haploid number of chromosome. For example, 3N and 4N. Monosomy X. Monosomy X is a genetic condition in which partially or completely missing of an X chromosome. Monosomy X is most common chromosomal abnormality in miscarriage. So remember that most common trisomy leading to miscarriage is trisomy 16, and most common chromosomal abnormality seen in miscarriage is monosomy X. Second one is endocrine and metabolic factor. LPD, luteal phase defect, result in early miscarriage because it does not support implantation and placentation adequately. Deficient progesterone secretion from the corpus luteum or poor endometrial response to progesterone does not hold the conceptors in the womb. Because progesterone with estrogen play an important role in maintenance of pregnancy. Overt hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism is associated with increased fetal loss. Poorly controlled diabetes mellitus cause increased miscarriage. Next factor is anatomical abnormalities. These are related to second trimester abortion. Cervical incompetence is one of the commonest causes of mid-trimester and recurrent abortion. Congenital malformation of the uterus in form of bicornate or septate uterus responsible for second trimester abortion. Causes of fetal loss are reduced intrauterine volume, reduced expansile property of the uterus, and reduced placental vascularity when implanted on septum. Uterine fibroid responsible for infertility and also for abortion. This is due to distortion or partial obliteration of the uterine cavity. Intrauterine adhesion or synechia interfere with implantation, placentation, and fetal growth. Infections are the accepted causes of late as well as early abortions. Transplacental fetal infections could be rubella, cytomegalovirus, HIV, toxoplasma, malaria, and many more. Immunological factors include antiphospholipid antibody syndrome and natural killer cells. Antiphospholipid antibody syndrome causes fetal hypoxia by inhibiting trophoblast function, releases inflammatory mediators, and formation of thrombosis in uteroplacental vascular bed. Smoking increases the risk due to formation of carboxyhemoglobin and decreased oxygen transfer to the fetus. IUD in the situ increases the risk of abortion. Next is threatened miscarriage. It is a clinical entity where the process of miscarriage has started but has not progressed to a state from which recovery is impossible. It means
Recovery is possible in threaten miscarriage. Clinical features. Patient complains for bleeding from vagina. It is usually slight and may be brownish or bright red in color. Bleeding usually stops spontaneously. Bleeding is usually painless, but there may be mild backache or dull pain in lower abdomen. Pain appears following hemorrhage. Pelvic examination should be done as gently as possible. Digital examination reveals close external OS. The uterine size corresponds to the period of amenorrhea. The uterus and cervical feel soft. Pelvic examination is avoided when USG is available. Routine investigations include blood for hemoglobin, hematocrit, ABO and Rh grouping. Anti-D gamma globulin has to be given in Rh negative non-immunized women. Serum progesterone 25 nanogram per ml or more indicate a viable pregnancy. Transvaginal sonography or TVS findings may be a well-formed gestational ring with central echoes from the embryo indicate a healthy fetus. Observation of fetal cardiac motion with this there is 98% chance of continuation of pregnancy. Management. The patient should be in bed for few days until bleeding stops. Prolonged restriction of activities has got no therapeutic values. Relief of pain may be ensured by tablet diazepam 5 mg twice daily. Inevitable miscarriage. It is a clinical type of abortion where the changes has progressed to a state from where continuation of pregnancy is impossible. It means recovery is not possible in inevitable miscarriage. The patient having the feature of threatened miscarriage develops the following manifestation. Increased vaginal bleeding, aggravation of pain in lower abdomen, which may be colicky in nature. Internal examination reveals dilated internal OS. Management. Management is aimed to accelerate the process of expulsion and to maintain strict asepsis. In active treatment, before 12 weeks, dilatation and evacuation followed by curettage of the uterine cavity by a blunt curette under general anesthesia. Alternatively, suction evacuation followed by curettage. And after 12 weeks, the uterine contraction is accelerated by oxytocin drip. If the fetus is expelled and the placenta is retained, it is removed by ovum forceps. If the placenta is not separated, digital separation followed by its evacuation is to be done under general anesthesia. Complete miscarriage. When the product of conception are expelled and masses miss completely, it is called complete miscarriage. Clinical features include there is history of expulsion of a fleshy mass per vaginum followed by subsidence of abdominal pain. Vaginal bleeding becomes trace or absent. Internal examination reveals uterus is smaller than the period of amenorrhea and little firmer. Cervical O is closed. Bleeding is usually trace and examination of expelled fleshy mass is found complete. TVS reveals empty uterine cavity. TVS. TVS is usually to see that uterine cavity is empty, otherwise evacuation of uterine cavity should be done. Rh negative patients should be protected by anti-D gamma globulin 50 microgram or 100 microgram in cases of early miscarriage or late miscarriage within 72 hours. Incomplete miscarriage. When the entire product of conception are not expelled, instead a part of it is left inside the uterine cavity, it is called incomplete miscarriage. Clinical features include expulsion of fleshy mass per vaginum followed by continuation of pain in lower abdomen, persistence of vaginal bleeding. Internal examination reveals uterus is smaller than the period of amenorrhea. On the examination, the expelled mass is found incomplete. Management. The retained product may cause profuse bleeding, sepsis, and placental polyp. So, in recent cases, evacuation of the retained product of conception or ERCP is done. In early abortion, dilatation and evacuation under analgesia or under general anesthesia is to be done. In late abortion, the uterus is evacuated under general anesthesia and the product are removed by ovum forceps or by blunt curette. In late cases, dilatation and curette is to be done to remove the bits of the tissue left behind. The removed material are subjected to histological examination. Missed miscarriage. When the fetus is dead and retained inside the uterus for a variable period, it is called missed miscarriage. Pathology. The causes of prolonged retention of a fetus inside the uterus are not clear. Beyond 12 weeks, the retained fetus become macerated or mummified. Before 12 weeks, the pathological process are differ when the womb is more or less completely surrounded by the chorionic villi. A small repeated hemorrhage inside the choriodistal space form a cavernous mole or a blood mole. Management. When the uterus is less than 12 weeks, many women expel the conceptus spontaneously. In medical management, misoprostol 800 mg vaginally in posterior fornix is given and repeated after 24 hours if needed. Expulsion usually occurs within 48 hours. Suction evacuation is done either a definitive treatment or it can be done when the medical method fails. When the uterus is more than 12 weeks, induction is done by the following methods. Prostaglandins are more effective than the oxytocin in such cases. The methods are misoprostol 200 microgram tablet is inserted into posterior vaginal fornix every 4 hours for a maximum of 5. Oxytocin, 10 to 20 units of oxytocin in 500 ml of NS at 30 drops per minute is started. Dilatation and evacuation is done once the cervix becomes soft with the use of prostaglandin. Even otherwise, the cervical canal is dilated using the mechanical dilator, also known as Agar's dilator, or by the laminaria tent. Septic abortion. Any abortion associated with clinical evidences of infection of the uterus and its contents is called septic abortion. Clinical manifestations include fever for 24 hours or more, offensive or purulent vaginal discharge, and lower abdomen pain and tenderness. Most of the septic abortions occur following illegal induced abortion. Mode of infection. The microorganisms involved in sepsis are usually endogenous. The microorganisms are anaerobic, usually Streptococci, Clostridium belgae, and Tetanus bacillus, and the aerobics, E. coli, Klebsiella, Staphylococcus, Pseudomonas, and group A beta hemolytic Streptococcus. Mixed infection is more common. The increased chance of sepsis in illegal induced abortion is due to proper antiseptic and sepsis are not taken. Incomplete evacuation and injury to genital organ and the adjacent structure, especially the bowel. There are three grades for the septic abortion. Grade first, when the infection is localized to the uterus and it is associated with the spontaneous abortion. In grade 2, the infection spread beyond the uterus to the perimetrium, tubes and ovaries or pelvic peritoneum. And in grade 3, generalized peritonitis, endotoxic shock or acute renal failure can occur, always associated with the illegal induced abortion. Complications are immediate and remote. Immediate complications are hemorrhage, generalized peritonitis, endotoxic shock, acute renal failure, and thrombophlebitis. Remote complications include chronic debility, chronic pelvic pain and backache, dyspareunia. Dyspareunia means pain during intercourse, ectopic pregnancy, secondary infertility due to the tubal blockage, and emotional depression. Hospitalization is essential for the patient, and the patient is kept in the isolation. To take the high vaginal or cervical swab for the culture, drug sensitivity, and the Gram stain. Normally, the vaginal examination is done to note the state of the abortion process and the extent of the infection. Prophylactic anti-gas gangrene serum and anti-tetanus serum is given if there is history of interference. For the pain management, analgesic and sedatives are also given. If the abortion is incomplete, evacuation should be performed at the convenient time within 24 hours following antibiotic therapy. For the management of grade 2, antibiotics are given. Blood transfusion is more often needed in grade 1. The evacuation should be withheld for at least 48 hours when the infection is controlled and is localized, the only exception being excessive bleeding. When the infection is localized in the pouch of Douglas, pelvic abscess is formed. It should be drained by the posterior colpotomy. Pelvic abscess is evidenced by the spiky rise of temperature and rectal tenesmus. For the management of grade 3, antibiotics are given, and management of endotoxic shock, renal failure if present. In active surgery, indications are injury to the uterus, suspected injury to the bowel, presence of the fun body in the abdomen as evidenced by sonography or x-ray. Indications of the active surgery are injury to the uterus, suspected injury to the bowel, presence of fun body in the abdomen, peritonitis. The laparotomy should be done by experienced surgeon with a skilled anesthetic. Removal of the uterus should be done irrespective of parity. Adnexa or ovaries is to be removed or preserved according to the pathology found. Even when nothing is found in laparotomy, simple drainage of pus is effective.